Hey guys, Marvel Studios has finally released a trailer for Ant-Man, the movie Ant-Man. This movie it starts the trailer starts off with like you hear Michael Douglas's voice in it. He's talking and it sounds like he's talking to Scott Lang kind of, but it starts flashing into different scenes in this movie. Like the first scene was a highway bridge, I think it was. And then there was like you see scenes like Scott Lang coming out of a jail cell and he's getting arrested. And then it comes down to Michael Douglas talking to him. And it was very interesting, the trailer, but it was very slow. I remember a Comic-Con teaser trailer that Edgar Wright gave us. And it was like you see Ant-Man running down the hallway and then he beams into this little tiny thing and he's like running down on the barrel of a gun and then he just slams into a guy's face and the guy that he slams into just flies by. I was hoping to see something like that in this trailer, like some major action. Like I know what they released the trailer for Joss Whedon's Avengers Age of Ultron trailer before this, and there was a lot of freaking interesting things in Ultron's trailer. I'm a huge fan of Ant-Man. I'm a huge fan of Marvel's Ant-Man comics. I was really stoked for this movie when Edgar Wright was being directing it, but as soon as they got Peyton Reed to take over, I kind of had lost all my hopes with this movie. This trailer was very interesting. I like it, and I know there's a lot of people out there saying they fucked up on Ant-Man's suit. You gotta realize this is not Hank Pym's Ant-Man, it's Scott Lang's Ant-Man. And I'll post some pictures in the back after this video of what Scott Lang's Ant-Man looked like in the comics. There's also Eric O'Grady's Ant-Man, and I think that's where people are coming from, where they're saying they're fucked up on his outfit. This trailer was very slow. It was very slow. There was not any action in it. The only action you saw in it was him shrinking in the bathtub and him going and looking up at a giant ant that he can ride. I was hoping to see some action in it. I was hoping to see Corey Stroll's character, Darren Cross, as Yellow Jacket in action in this trailer. Maybe like a glimpse of Darren Cross's Yellow Jacket uniform. Not the Darren Cross in a business suit walking down with a bald head. I gotta say, Darren Cross in this trailer, he did not look like Darren Cross from the comics. Did not. He looked more like freaking Egghead. Not Darren Cross. Now, for the actors in this movie, Paul Rudd is perfect for Scott Lang. Other hand, on Hank Pym as old man Hank Pym, there could have been a better casting job with it. Michael Douglas does not look like a superhero type. He's skinny. He's too old looking. He just doesn't look like he used to be a first Avenger type guy or even a superhero at one point. The few actors I would have wanted to see play Hank Pym as an old guy, if that's what they're going to do, is making Hank Pym like a mentor, like a Yoda to Scott Lang in this. I would have wanted to see like Mel Gibson or Kurt Russell or Harrison Ford play Hank Pym in this movie, because eventually Scott Lang in the comics, he gets captured in the comics and Hank Pym is forced to put his Ant-Man suit on to save Scott Lang eventually. And Michael Douglas is not in the shape to do that. He is not in the shape to do that if they go that far in the story. That's why I was really had my fingers crossed for Kurt Russell and Mel Gibson to play old Hank Pym when I heard the rumors that Hank Pym was not going to be the main Ant-Man in the movie. He was more going to be like a mentor, a Yoda type character. Like you know like how Yoda was Luke to Luke Skywalker. Well, this is Hank Pym as Yoda to Scott Lang. It's Ant-Man in this. He's a mentor. He invents gadgets, new things and different things. Teaches him how to use the suit and teaches him how. Scott Lang is a thief in the comics. He's not a family man. This is a total new story. Like I have to say, Peyton Reed got fired from Fantastic Four for a reason. Now he's taken Ant-Man a little too far in his hands. He's not following the stories. Marvel Studios should have stuck with Edgar Wright for the movie. Come on, Marvel Studios. But anyways, the trailer was pretty interesting. Till next time, you guys.